In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If your vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
Joe had huge problems with the IRS.
I knew it was coming. I hadn't filed taxes since 1990.
All the IRS letters coming in added up to a nightmare.
To get up to like $68,000, my heart started beating fast. It's like, there's no way, man. I mean, I ain't gonna be able to do this.
Then they stopped his paycheck.
So that's when I started making phone calls and found U.S. Tax Shield.
U.S. Tax Shield went to work immediately.
They just took the bull by the horns. What blew my mind is he called the IRS right then and there.
So why is U.S. Tax Shield A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau? Joe knows.
They saved me a ridiculous amount of money.
If you owe more than $10,000 to the IRS or state, choose the company Joe chose, U.S. Tax Shield.
It was the best decision I made. U.S. Tax Shield is the way to go. Life is good. Thank you, Lord.
Call 800-471-3287.
U.S. Tax Shield. Boo-rah. Yes.
800-471-3287. 800-471-3287.
K98 Talk is expanding its lineup for 2015. This means we are expanding our advertising base. Whether you're a startup trying to push through to the next level or an established business trying to supplement your advertising budget, web-based advertising is a solid investment. Thanks to Talk's newest partnership with TuneIn Radio and instant access to our sister station, K98 FM, we give you worldwide access at a reasonable cost. Interested parties should email us at advertise@k98talk.org. The leader in talk radio on the internet, right here on K98 Talk and the Spark Radio Network.
Well, good evening, folks. This is Rick Robinson, and it's Friday Night in America, and it is a time for change and choosing. That is the title of this evening's episode. Now, before we get into the gist of the episode, do want to do the usual and give a shout-out to the affiliates. So for everyone listening live right now, of course, you're listening on either the Spark Radio Network or K98talk.org, where the show can be heard every Monday through Friday, typically at 10-ish Central, 11 Eastern. I'm the boss, so nobody can really yell at me too much if for some reason we start a couple minutes late here and there, which tonight was one of those nights, so for those of you waiting for me, I do apologize. All right, then of course we have amfm247.com, where this show can be heard every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 1 Eastern. There are 8 low-power affiliates there, as well as their live 365 stream. We then have SHR Media, where the show can be heard every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 11 Eastern in the morning. Then we have Leading Edge Radio Network, where the show can be heard every Monday through Friday at 8 Eastern, 7 Central in the morning. Then we have Red State Talk Radio, where you can actually hang out with me, not tomorrow morning, but the day after, really, really early, 6 Eastern, 5 Central, but it's a great network. I enjoy being over there. Then, of course, we have High Point Radio, which was the second terrestrial group to pick us up, which is out of Montauk, New Jersey. Really great group of folks over there. If you're in the New Jersey area, I do encourage you to check them out from time to time. But, of course, in New Jersey, Philly, and the surrounding areas, our crown jewel, our piece de resistance for our terrestrial networks that we're building, the WNJC 1360 AM Philadelphia, the powerhouse, where the show can be heard every Thursday at 2 Eastern. We are working on more time slots, but so far, just not able to pull the plug on that yet, only because I want to make sure that when I'm over there, it's always really spot on, and I don't always have the ability to do 5 shows a week right now, even though I have that much time reserved in the hopes that I can bring good content 5 nights a week. But we find ways to make it happen usually anyway, but not all of it would I want to be heard by millions and millions of people like happens when I'm on in Philly. But anyway, before we get into the show, I just want to take a second. You guys that have been listening in for the last couple of nights, probably hearing me starting out with different music. It's mainly because it's stuff that's kind of been in my heart now for months, and I just didn't really know why. I'm really... The show may change for a while, folks, because I'm really starting to be terrified that we are running out of time, which is, again, why the title of tonight's show is A Time for Change and Choosing. We will get right into that, though, as soon as we pay a few bills. This is Rick Robinson. I'm the host of America Off the Rails. We'll be right back with you here in about three and a half. Alright folks, this is Rick Robinson with you. I want to tell you about some friends of mine from a company called Security Enforcement Specialists. When I ran my security agency for 12 years, I worked with one of these partners on a daily basis. He's been involved in this agency now, and with his other partner, they do have over 30 years of experience in the private security industry. If you own a business and you need someone to keep you or your customers or residents safe, then I highly recommend contacting Security Enforcement Specialists today. Give them a call at 405-703-1796. Again, that's 405-703-1796. Again, tell them Rick from K98 Talk sent you. Like I said, if you need the help, they are here for you. So make sure that you go look them up, check them out, and see what they can do. The wrong way. Welcome to the place.
K98 Talk is expanding its lineup for 2015. This means we are expanding our advertising base. Whether you're a startup trying to push through to the next level or an established business trying to supplement your advertising budget, web-based advertising is a solid investment. Thanks to Talk's newest partnership with TuneIn Radio and instant access to our sister station, K98 FM, we give you worldwide access at a reasonable cost. Interested parties should email us at advertise@k98talk.org.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Socialists, butthurt, hippie, tree huggers, please exit the facility immediately. Again, attention please. America Off the Rails is now designated as a conservative safe zone only. All but her tree-hugging hippie freebie you and me types exit the facility immediately. Thank you.
We will keep this promise to the American people. If you like your doctor, you will be able to keep your doctor, period. If you like your health care plan, you will be able to keep your health care plan, period.
This is the most transparent administration in history. Not even a smidgen of corruption.
Fact is, we had four dead Americans. What difference at this point does it make?
If you got a business, you didn't build that.
Oh, welcome to the face. Welcome to the face of the new democracy. Come expect us to admit a mistake. We're paying off election debts to those on the take. Attorney General's lying even while...
It's time to hear the truth about America's biggest challenges. You're listening to America Off the Rails with your host, Rick Robinson.
All right, folks. Well, again, good evening. It is Friday night in America. We finally made it. The week is over. We have Saturday and Sunday to relax. Well, some of you do. I'll be working pretty much most of the day tomorrow. If you're listening right now and you don't typically tune in on Saturdays, make sure you get up early with us. We have Finding Common Ground, where I go toe-to-toe with one of two usual liberal co-hosts. I do believe tomorrow will be the usual Mr. Bryce Robbins. And then, of course, if you're conservative and you want your ears to bleed, you should hang out afterwards, too. He does another hour all by himself. That's right, folks. We are equal opportunity torturers around here. So if you happen to be a liberal or no liberals that are looking for some interesting takes on a few things, you might want to have them check out Bryce. If you are like me and typically like to get a little bit of both sides of the aisle, you might want to check it out too. Because the interesting thing about Bryce, he started out really, really liberal. We've been working together now and doing a show now for, wow, actually it's almost a year. And he's changed quite a bit, much to his chagrin. But anyway, enough plugging the show for tomorrow. All right, so where to start? You know, here's my problem. And I have lots of sound clips and other stuff that we'll get to tonight, but I have something I have to get off my chest first. Does anybody remember when we thought that, you know, we had finally put the race issue to bed because, you know, we finally elected a black president, so everybody was like, oh, everybody can breathe a sigh of relief now because everything's going to be so much better because we finally put race behind us. This president has done everything that he can to put race back in front of us. And I think there are some undertones there that actually bleed over into the California situation, which we're going to get to tonight, I promise, because there's still so many more things to talk about there. We have some audio from Barbara Boxer. We have the FBI finally catching up to the rest of us that had more than two brain cells to rub together and saying, hey, this is terrorism, guys. better late to the party than never, fellas. But yeah. We know it's terrorism now. But, you know, here's the thing. There's two ways to look at Obama. He's either the most inept commander-in-chief ever and makes Barney Fife look like Albert Einstein. Or he has an agenda. I'm not here to tell you what I think. I'm here to make you think. Well, actually, yeah. Let me rephrase that. I'm here to tell you what I think, but not tell you what to think. What I'm trying to do is hopefully make you think. So I'm going to give you my opinions. That's what this show's about. My opinions, laced with news stories and facts and other things, and then I hope that you draw your own conclusions. But let me tell you, after watching this man for 7 years, what I'm starting to understand, and one of the reasons why I say at this point we have hit a time for change and a time for choosing. Because the simple fact of the matter is, it's time to figure out which side you're on. Because if you're part of this go-along-to-get-along crowd, like the Republicans have been for the last 7 years... Oh, we'll get to them too, because they're suddenly making noise about possibly finding their spines. I'm still convinced that the majority of them couldn't find their rear ends with both hands. But we'll get to them too, because there was a surprise move in the Senate last night that I think, I'm sure by now you've heard about it, but I'll give you my take on it anyway. But so my question to you tonight, and then I will spend the rest of the show giving you my perspectives and what my answers to this are, is Obama inept, or does he have an agenda? Because either way, it's time for a change. It's time to do something. doesn't really matter what it is at this point. And I'm, before anybody says anything and knows, like, yes, I'm looking at you. Put it back in the locker, brother. It's not that time yet. No, and I didn't tell. No, put it down. You know, it's not that time yet. Sadly, it might be getting closer than I want it to be, but I'm still telling you it's not that time. Just it's all right. Just put it down. Put it down. Okay, so now we can move on. I think I've managed to talk Slick off of the armed conflict moment, maybe. Okay, so, anyway. So, let's get into, of course, the now two-night-in-a-row major story. I guess I'm going to start with my idiot of the day. Pretty easy pick on that one. I may actually... Sad thing is, if I really stopped and thought about it, I probably could do an idiot of the day. Maybe for now we'll start with idiot of the week, and maybe I will do it on Fridays. This one is, pretty self-evident. Let me hear you. Wow, get paid to talk for a living. Can't seem to pull it off.
Sensible gun laws work. We've proven it in California, and we're not going to give up.
What do you say we hear that again? I'm not sure I heard it right, and it was kind of a short clip.
Sensible gun laws work. We've proven it in California, and we're not going to give up.
Okay, so if anybody's wondering, that's Barbara Boxer. So let's listen to this one more time.
Sensible gun laws work. We've proven it in California, and we're not going to give up.
Wow. So I guess it's a really terrible thing that they didn't have sensible gun laws in San Bernardino, Indiana. What the hell? Sensible gun laws work in California? Really? Correct me if I'm wrong. You know, I'm in Oklahoma. I'm in flyover country. Maybe I'm reading the map wrong. Isn't San Bernardino in California? How are those sensible gun laws working for you now? Just curious, because you make the whole inability to put together coherent thought when bad things happen makes absolutely no sense to me. Just as a bit of a side note, you know, a few weeks ago, about two weeks now, there was a major attack in Paris. Everybody started screaming, you know, pray for Paris. America stands with Paris. Pray for Paris. And we have people here that are attacked. And nobody wants to admit it's terrorism. Can't do that. No. You know, in the beginning of it, you could practically see the liberals dancing in the streets when they were pretty sure they were buying into their own narrative and that it was Christian conservative white guys that were trying to shoot up a building that was 2 miles from a Planned Parenthood. Or the other, and I'll play the audio in a minute, but I played it last night. I'll play it again just so you know I'm not making it up. Then there's the other guy that was like, oh, but these are guys that are shooting up government employees in a government... at a government holiday party, so maybe it's right-wing extremist anti-government nuts. Really? Really? That's what you got for us? Speaking of, you know what, we might as well just play it now. What the heck? These are some of the crazy things that the liberal media has been saying ever since the San Bernardino incident. And then we have another one that I want to play, just because it really annoyed me.
Are we mature enough as a country to look in the mirror and say, we have a gun problem? You know, a 12-step program starts with, you got to acknowledge you have a problem. Are we mature enough to acknowledge that?
Then what could it be?
It could be some right-wing group, for all I know.
And attacking a government function. If it's county employees having some type of a banquet there, that takes on more of a domestic militia group, an anti-government domestic militia group wanting to attack the government.
Well, we can tell you that the Planned Parenthood, actually, of San Bernardino is only a few blocks away.
We know how to fix it. Congress resolutely refuses to do it. But I think that
the president also, you know, showing signs of the frustration we've seen from him so many times. He spoke at the funeral for the victims in Charleston. He spoke out in Washington State. He has spoken after Sandy Hook, always coming out calling for more measures to make it more difficult for people to have access to kind of weapons that can pull off these kind of mass shootings. It's been one of the great frustrations of his presidency.
You know, some may be aware of the fact that we have a no-fly list where people can't get on planes, but those same people who we don't allow to fly could go into a store right now in the United States and buy a firearm, and there's nothing that we can do to stop them.
In a situation like this, very often the perpetrators intend to commit, you know, murder or suicide by cops. So whether or not there are armed guards there, it's not going to make any difference.
Does this go back to our revolution? We're revolutionary people. We really don't believe in government.
This was a holiday party. Maybe it was called a Christmas party. I mean, there's so many potential triggers here.
He was triggered, folks, because it was a Christmas party. Then you've got Tingles, Chris Matthews. Oh my God! It's because
we're a revolutionary society. Is a voice of evil. Shooters are evil. That people who stand by and do nothing and say nothing can be done to fix problems—that's a voice of evil too.
And then, of course, this last nozzle. Oh, all you people that are doing nothing are saying that we can't do anything. You're just as evil as the terrorists. Really? Everything that you guys say you want for the rest of the country, California already has. Did it stop it there? No? Then sit down and shut up. We don't have a gun problem in this country. We have a hate problem in this country. And no, I'm not going moral. Right now, there are some liberals that are listening and their ears just completely perked up. And they're like, oh, he's about to start ripping into us for how much we hate on other countries. No, kind of vice versa. Because we're the first ones that run in with aid, we're the first ones that run in with help anytime anything goes wrong, and we have an entire population and segment of a society that want us dead. I have a problem with that, which is why I'm saying at this point it is a time for change and a time for choosing, and you need to figure out which side you're on. If you're going to keep being part of the namby-pamby, milquetoast, hug-a-tree hippie group, just turn off the radio. I don't want to talk to you anymore. I don't even want to know you exist anymore, because you are going to be the death of this country. Political correctness is a religious movement, whether you want to admit it or not. Too many of you are willing to die for the beliefs about political correctness when you look at the things that I'm willing to die for and look and talk about me like I'm an idiot. The difference is, I know I have religious beliefs. You don't even want to admit that you do. But you are willing to let in the people that have admitted they want to kill us and that they are going to sneak people into the country that are willing to kill us because they want us dead. But because you cannot handle not being the warm fuzzy, gotta follow with the feels guy, or gotta lead with the feels guy, you're gonna let the same people in this country that want us dead. I have a problem with that. I have a problem with all of you. I understand wanting to be the good guy. I understand wanting to always wear the white hat. But here's my point. When all of you namby-pamby, milquetoast some bitches will unlock all of your doors and windows at night, then you can talk to me about what we need to do at our border. Because if you're not willing to let anybody come into your home anytime they want to and take anything from you that they need more than you do, then you don't have any room to talk to me about what we need to do with our borders and how many people we need to let in here and what type of people we need to let in here. Because the simple fact of the matter is there are things in this country that need to be fixed. Our immigration program is one of them, but we don't need to swing the gates open wide and not pay attention at all to the people that come in here. This is case in point. These people, one of them was an American citizen, for God's sake. Working a government job, making $70,000 a year, had enough time off that he could go to Saudi Arabia for a month on more than one occasion, brought back a wife who was vetted by the same group that tells us they're going to vet the refugees that want to come across the border. Within 12 months, she's shooting up a building. Why? Because we vetted her so well, we didn't realize that she had pledged allegiance to ISIS on Facebook. Way to keep track, American government. But you're the same people that say, trust us, we can monitor these people as they come in, and we'll know which ones want to do us harm before they do. No, we won't, because you don't want us to know. The only thing you're concerned about is trying to find a way to make sure that you hold on to all of your power. And this is just another way to get it done. What concerns me, and this was brought up by somebody today, I want to try to give credit for it, so I'm trying to find the actual area where I heard it. So bear with me for just a second. It's going to take me a second to track it down if I can. It's in a rather busy Twitter group. Nope, going to take too long. I don't want to give you guys a bunch of dead air. Anyway, there's a group that I'm in on Twitter that and one of the folks in there actually made a comment today that made the hair on the back of my neck stand up. That they're pretty sure that this attack is going to wind up being the catalyst that not only gives Trump the nomination, but eventually the White House. Which is everything that I've been afraid of this entire time. Because Trump is not who he leads us to think that he is. You can see behind his mask when he lets you. He is a very angry person. That is not always a good thing. Anger can be good when you harness it and you put it to good use. And I'm not saying that maybe in his past he hasn't, but the bad thing about being that angry, as visibly angry as he is, much like the president that we have now, look what he has done with that anger. He hasn't tried to reach across the aisle. He hasn't tried to work with the other side. He lashes out as a vindictive child would because he's angry. Obama is angry about the way his father and his grandfather were treated by the British Empire, apparently. There are several other things that he's angry about. Trump has a lot of the same issues, but for different reasons. He has anger. You can see it when he lashes out. This is not the type of person that we need to have full control of a nuclear arsenal in this country. He's not. He's already called for censorship against people that speak out against him in the press. That's what we want our president to do. But the scary thought of it is, with as devout as his followers are, and yes, I said devout, with as devout as his followers are, and the rise now of terrorism in this country, I mean, come on, look back at the last 7 years. How many terrorist attacks have we had in the last 7 years? A lot more than anybody wants to talk about, because half the time they won't even admit they are terrorist attacks. Unless they absolutely positively don't have a choice. This one happened at a work function, so they pushed it for 48 hours to try to make it sound like workplace violence. They couldn't pull it off. So eventually even the FBI had to concede, well, looks like it's terrorism, boys and girls. I don't know why it took us 48 hours to draw that conclusion. Because you know everybody that does any type of workplace violence comes in with an AK-74 and body armor with explosive improvised devices. Yeah, that's how we roll up in here. I mean, come on, dude. I mean, seriously, who are you, Barney Fife? You really, for a day and a half, were trying to tell... We don't want to jump to any conclusions, folks. This might not be terrorism. It might be workplace violence. Yeah, that's the same thing they said about Fort Hood. Let that sink in for a second. This is the type of people that we're dealing with in this administration, whether anyone wants to believe it or not. These are the people that we're dealing with. Let this sink in for a second. This same group that for 36 hours, or pretty damn close to 36 hours, kept trying to push the narrative that this was possibly workplace violence, are the same ones that tried to blame the Benghazi terror attack on a video and went so far, even after now when they tried to deny that that wasn't what they meant, told the parents of those that were lost in that attack that they were going to bring to justice the maker of the video, but it wasn't what they meant. This administration and our government cannot afford to lose control of their narrative. Their narrative is that Islam is peaceful. I'm here to tell you I no longer believe that. You can call me an Islamophobe. I have a different definition of that than you do. I told you last night that one of the things I am done doing is listening to people try to tell me that my religion and Islam are basically the same. My religion tells me to love others. Their religion tells them to kill others. My religion tells me to treat my wife and my mate as if she was part of me and to take care of her, to nurture her, and vice versa for the other side of the equation too. They're taught to treat their wives like property. They're taught that it's okay to rape their wives. They're taught that it's okay to have sex with animals because it doesn't count. These are the things that are in that book. I'm not making this up. So until they have a visible reformation, like the segment that I played last night where a former Muslim was talking about the fact that it is time to do an actual reformation of Islam, until that happens, as far as I'm concerned, they're all the enemy. I don't care anymore. We have to do something to stay safe. It really is that simple. And I'm not saying mark them all. I'm not saying round them up. I'm saying in this day and age, we have the ability to be able to monitor folks without making their lives living hells. And it's time that we start using the technology that we have available. There is no way, no way. I mean, I don't know what to do anymore because I feel like in one extreme, I'm going way too far in one direction. And in another extreme, I'm going way too far in the other. But I really don't know what to do here. So I'm just off the cuff telling you exactly how I feel. If it costs me listeners, fine. If people turn off the show, fine. I don't care anymore. I didn't start any of this as a popularity contest. I don't have any illusions that I'm ever going to be the next Sean Hannity or the next Rush Limbaugh. What I am going to be is a guy that's always going to try to tell you the truth to the best of my ability, at least as I see it at that time, but I do deal in opinion. So you will hear my opinions change. That's not flip-flopping. It's not anything. It's just the simple fact of the matter is I have changed my mind. And I'm telling you right now, I don't know what the answer is. But what I do know is that we have got to do some serious thinking and make some serious changes. And one of the things that I will tell you when we come back from break is one of the things that I think we actually could do to make some changes and why I think it's a good idea. We'll be right back here in just a couple minutes. Alright folks, this is Rick Robinson with you. I want to tell you about some friends of mine from a company called Security Enforcement Specialists. When I ran my security agency for 12 years, I worked with one of these partners on a daily basis. He's been involved in this agency now, and with his other partner, they do have over 30 years of experience in the private security industry. If you own a business and you need someone to keep you or your customers or residents safe, then I highly recommend contacting Security Enforcement Specialists today. Give them a call at 405-703-1796. Again, that's 405-703-1796. Again, tell them Rick from K98 Talk sent you. Like I said, if you need the help, they are here for you. So make sure that you go look them up, check them out, and see what they can do. The wrong way. Welcome to the
We will never fully understand what we've asked of our military service members or their families, asking them to put themselves in harm's way, to endure it all. But we do understand that it's our turn, our duty, to keep them secure for the rest of their lives. Wounded Warrior Project long-term support programs help our most severely ill or injured veterans live independently, at no cost, for life, so that they might stand at ease. Join us at findwwp.org.
The staff of K98 Talk and the Spark Radio Network is proud to announce that our very own Rowdy Rick Robinson has been selected as one of the top conservative talk show hosts in the nation for his program, America Off the Rails. Again, congratulations to Rowdy Rick Robinson for a job well done and another reason to stay connected to K98 Talk and the Spark Radio Network.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 $3 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention?
Phone calls, may I be the telephone to buy me some applause? Political courageous will replace the Bill of Rights. Support religious freedom, bless you, pray to Jesus Christ. The grass is in our pockets, cause it's no longer free. You cannot make a move now that the NSA can see. Don't expect equality, respect, or fair play. The IRS will target those who vote the wrong way.
All right, folks, we're back. We're live. This is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robinson, and we are into the last half of the show. So as promised, we're going to still touch on a few more topics. One of the things that I've kind of felt led to talk about, and I keep putting it off, but I'm running out of time, and I keep getting the nudge to go ahead and bring it up. Again, a time for change and a time for choosing. It's, again, time to choose what side you're on, and I'm going to tell you right now. One of the things that can change this country again, that can steal, to steal Donald Trump's slogan, there is a way to make this country great again. Doesn't have anything to do with Donald Trump. It is time to turn our face back to God. We have turned away as a nation. We slaughter children on a daily basis because they're a nuisance, because nobody's got time for them, because they didn't want them in the first place. They want the act that brings them the pleasure that might result in creating a child, but they don't want the child afterwards. So not only now do we slaughter them, which is bad enough, but now we have found, our companies have found ways to make money off of the baby body parts. We have an entire segment of the world that wants us dead because they view us as the great Satan. I don't say these things lightly. What I tell you is that these things are being allowed to happen for a reason. It's up to you to determine what you think those reasons are. But I am telling you that one of the things that I will be beginning to do, starting effective tomorrow, is for the next 40 days, I will pray every day for this nation at least twice a day. I'm not telling you that you have to. I'm not asking you to. I'm just telling you what I'm going to do. I would encourage you to, because one of the things that I have been doing lately is looking back at some of the pivotal moments in our nation and realizing that prayer was centered around a lot of those pivotal moments. Up until Abraham Lincoln called for a day of thanksgiving and prayer, we were losing the Civil War. And I've been going back and rereading a lot of the history with that too, and hearing about it from other places, and it's not nearly the sanitized whitewash version of this that we've heard. There have been so many different versions of what's happened, but one of the things that nobody really takes into account is the brutality of the folks in the South at that time. They were skinning black soldiers from the North when those soldiers lost. Let that sink in for a second. Just realize how barbaric we have actually been in the past for what a lot of us may have thought were the best reasons. I've heard the same arguments that you've heard for a long time now, that the Civil War had more to do with states' rights than it did with slavery. But if you really dig into it, it was both. There was an entire segment of our country that depended on slave labor. But before anybody says, oh, he's just beating up on the South, let's not forget that some little-known writings of Lincoln's actually had mentioned that he had planned on, if he had survived, rounding up and removing the majority of, in his words, the Negro population from our continent. So my point is, there comes a time in our lives when we have to make choices and we have to make decisions. Our government continues to make, in my estimation, what are the wrong decisions. They think it's best to hide things from their people. They think it's best to make things up as they go along. They seem to think that we're so stupid that we need to be spoon-fed information instead of telling us the truth. And they do these same things time and time and time again, and before anybody says anything, that is regardless of administration or party affiliation, they all do the same thing, just some of them are worse than others. This current administration, really, 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 really terrible. Does anybody remember when he said he was going to be the most transparent administration ever, the most transparent president ever, that anytime any major bills came up, they were going to be available online for review, there would be major discussions on C-SPAN regarding things like Obamacare? Yeah, none of that happened. Speaking of things that I thought were never going to happen, since we are getting to the end of the show, I have to, for about 2 seconds, give some props to the Republican Party, because they finally decided to apparently find their spine, although I think it has more to do with their sense of self-preservation than it does any intestinal fortitude. And they've suddenly decided it's a good idea in the Senate to pass a measure that would repeal Obamacare. That's funny. The House has done that several times now. Why is the Senate just now doing it? How many months away from an election cycle are we again? I'm sorry, do they think we're so stupid that we're not going to notice? Like I said, it's self-preservation. They've been telling us when we voted for them the last time, we'll have all of this done the first 5 days we're there. First 10 days we're there. First 15 days we're there. How many days they've been there? Heck of a lot more than 5, 10, or 15. So that's what I'm saying. That's what the recurring theme has been for this entire episode. It's time for change. And not the Obama-style change. It is time for real, true change. One of the first things that we can do ourselves to initiate change is to turn our face back to God. And I know there are some of you that listen to the show that are not Christian, and I'm not belittling you. All I'm telling you is right now I'm speaking to the Christians. Because whether anybody wants to admit it or not, these are precursors to some very dark days. These days have been foretold. All you got to do is pick up the book and turn to the last one. It outlines pretty well everything that's going on right now. Do I think we're in the last days yet? Probably not. Do I think we're getting pretty damn close? Unfortunately, yes. So as we do get drawn more and more into this inevitable situation that a lot of us knew was coming, it's time to choose. Are you going to sit in the sidelines or are you going to get involved? The first thing you got to do is pick a side. You're either going to be on the side that is for America or the side that is against America. And if you're for the side that's against America, then do everybody a favor and just turn off your radio, your phone, or however you're listening to this show right now, and just go away. I don't have time for the negativity anymore. I don't have time for the drama anymore. We have conservatives that are fighting amongst ourselves all because we disagree on who our candidate needs to be. We have bigger problems. We are about to be in a fight for our survival, whether anybody wants to admit it or not. This is exactly what the incident in California has shown me. This is how easy they can get to us now. That's what they wanted us to know. We're not safe here any longer. That's what they wanted us to know. We are not safe. They wanted the folks in Paris to know, you are not safe. We can get to you no matter where you are, because when it counted, you were idiots and you let us come in here. They told us what they were going to do if we let them come in here. And we did it anyway. And then you have idiots like this guy. Idiots like this guy. Listen to what this guy asked the wife of one of the people that was killed. Listen to this. This is insane.
And he just wanted to evangelize to everybody, and that's what he did.
Did he evangelize with this guy, Farouk?
I'm sure he would have talked to him and probably evangelized with him. I'm sure they would have had discussions about religion, because my husband wouldn't discuss religion with anybody that would listen, and the fact that they were coming from two different backgrounds. But as far as I know, there had been no arguments or bad feelings or anything like that prior to what happened yesterday.
You've been open about this, and so has your husband, about what he has said about Muslims in the past.
Yes.
What has he said?
He's very upset about what ISIS has been doing and the radicalized Muslims, Al-Qaeda, the whole situation. He's upset about the fact that the majority of the Muslims, you know, it's like they won't come out and do something about it. It's like,
so do you think he talked to Farouk about that?
He might have.
She has no direct evidence that they had ever had a confrontation or anything.
She has no direct evidence they had a confrontation. She has no direct evidence they even had a conversation about religion, but she says he made a point, her husband, of talking to everyone he worked with, the health department, about his beliefs about being born again.
Did he evangelize with this guy, Farouk, what he has said about Muslims in the past? What has he said? Do you think he talked to Farouk about that?
He made a point talking to everyone about his beliefs. He made a point talking to everyone about his beliefs.
You keep asking more. Asking more.
I mean, come on. The dude's dead, and you're asking his wife basic questions that lead to the answer of, do you think your husband was asking to get killed by this guy because he was shoving his religion down his throat? Are you kidding me right now? Is this who we have become? We attack the victims and victimize the attackers now? Because that's what's been happening. You listen to this guy's family and they're like, oh my god, little Farouki was such a good guy. We had no way of knowing he was going to do this. It had to be the harlot's fault. It had to. He was such a good little boy. This is the world we live in now. We demonize the people that are being attacked and victimize the attackers. And then you try to tell me it was workplace violence for 36 hours until now. Listen, they finally admitted it today.
I want to go forward today and tell you that as of today, based on the information and the facts as we know them, we are now investigating these horrific acts as an act of terrorism. We have uncovered evidence that it has led us to learn of extensive planning. Obviously, we've uncovered evidence of explosive, multiple armaments. You know that. You know the ammunition that was out there, the high-powered weapons, the explosive devices. We are continuing to go down the path to ensure that we find all of the evidence that pertains to this matter. We have also uncovered evidence that these subjects they attempted to destroy their digital fingerprints.
Joining us right now is former FBI National Joint Terrorism Task Force member Steve Rogers. Hedge CEO.
All right, so there you hear it from, what was his name? David Bowditch, the assistant director of the California FBI field office, basically admitting today, oh my God, we were wrong, folks. It's terrorism. Let me get my bullet out of my pocket now and get my gun loaded, because I was too stupid 36 hours ago to realize that, you know, that workplace violence doesn't involve body armor and AK-74s and improvised explosive devices and people coming and going at all hours of the night. Do you know the scariest thing about all of this? The scariest thing about all of this is there were neighbors that were watching these things happen. Watching strange people come and go at all hours of the night. Watching them come in with boxes and leave with boxes. And all kinds of things. And you know what? Lives could have been saved. But you know what happened instead? We have an administration that demonizes anyone who says anything bad about anybody that ain't white. So these couple of neighbors went, well, I don't want to be accused of racial profiling. I'm not going to be the one to make that phone call. 14 people are dead. How many are wounded? All because somebody was afraid to pick up a phone. Would it have solved the problem? Who knows? But at least maybe it would have started a domino effect that might have at least saved some lives. But we can't do that anymore because we can't have common sense in this country anymore. Common sense isn't allowed. You have to listen to the government. The government knows what's best and they're going to take care of you, so you better listen to them. Chris Rock said basically that thing. So many people in Hollywood have said almost exactly the same thing. Do you realize there is a provision in the law? Governance patriae. I butchered it because I don't speak Latin. But the general translation is, at some point, when necessary, the government has the legal obligation to step in and act as someone's parents in the event that they are unable to make rational decisions on their own. What possible purpose could that serve? You tell me. I don't understand this country anymore. All I can tell you is we are about out of time, and I don't mean just for the show. America as we know it will cease to exist before we realize it because we've been too busy asleep at the switch. We have abdicated our responsibilities. We have turned too much control over to the government. We have automated most of the things that we need to remain in control of. That is in so many levels. You're complaining about your healthcare costs, yet half the time you don't even know what it's going to cost when you go to the doctor because you don't care. Because if you have insurance, you don't pay it. You pay a copay. The insurance and the doctor's office haggle. Half the cost winds up usually going away anyway, or the insurance company says they're only going to pay for half, and then the doctor tries to send you a bill, and then you got to go to court to deal with the rest of it. But what do you care? You have insurance, right? That's how we look at Congress now. I don't need to worry about this stuff. That's what I send these folks to Washington for. I don't need to deal with this. That's what I have a government for. I don't need to take care of my neighbor. That's why I pay taxes. Why do I need to give my time to a homeless shelter or my money to a homeless shelter when I pay taxes? Why do I need to do anything when I pay taxes? Why do I need to be the one to get involved? Because if not you, then who? It's a pretty simple concept, and we've lost track of it. Completely and totally. And tonight, my heart is breaking. It has been now for months, and I couldn't figure out why. Because I got to tell you, right now, I'm not trying to brag, but personal life and professional life right now, I'm doing pretty good. I've been nationally syndicated talk show on several different platforms. I have a day job that I enjoy. Just bought a new house. My youngest son, who had to change schools, is adjusting well, which was one of my concerns. But there's been this nagging thing in the back of my mind for weeks. It's been there for longer than that, but it's getting louder. And it gets louder every single day. And it's because, again, the one thing that this week and the couple of weeks prior to this have taught me is we're out of time and we've made bad choices. As a nation, we have made terrible choices. We have made the decision that God no longer matters. And I know for some of you, that seems like a perfectly rational decision because to you, God is nothing but a myth. I tell you that if you look, you'll find him. And it's not Allah. despite what some people want you to think. So in closing, as I often do, I'm going to tell you the same thing that I used to try to tell you every single show, but then again, back then I was usually only doing about once a week. It's time to get involved. Even if you disagree with 99.999997% of what just came out of my mouth, you've got to get off the couch. You've got to put down the remote. You've got to find a way to get involved. We are running out of time to take this country back. I don't care if you're a Democrat. I don't care if you're a Republican. What I care about is we have too many Americans on the sidelines when it matters. We have too many Americans that have bought into the free-to-be-you-and-me hug-a-tree hippie crap, and they're not doing anything anymore because they don't think they have to, because it's not their responsibility. I tell you today, this evening, on Friday, December the 4th, 2015, at just about 5 minutes before the hour of midnight Eastern, 11 Central, it is your responsibility to make this country great again. Stop letting Trump take what is your responsibility and run with it, because you know he's not going to do it right anyway. He doesn't care about you. He's telling you what you need to hear. When it comes right down to it, none of the people that are currently running for office give a damn about you. So what you need to do is decide which one aligns most with what you need to get done and what you think needs to happen, and that's the guy that you run with. And you hope to God and pray to God every single day that they're not just telling you what you need to hear and that it's not just going to be more of the same old. But if it is, then we can deal with that when the time comes. But right now, we have got to make a decision. Do you want another 4 years of the same type of stuff that we've got right now? Because if you do, then you might as well vote for Clinton, or hell, you might as well vote for Trump. Because how can the guy who wanted Hillary to be president in 2008 now run against her in 2016 and say that she's not good enough to be president? In 2008, she was your woman, brother. She was the one you wanted to be president. You gave her money in the hopes that she would become president. And you've already admitted the reason you did that was because you knew that she would owe you a favor. So my question to you, even though you don't want anybody to know this, how many people do you owe favors to right now? Because you keep making all this noise about how you're the one that's funding your own campaign, and you're the one that's doing this, and you've got the talking heads like Limbaugh and Hannity talking about how you've got the biggest crowds ever, and blah, 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 blah. And simple fact of the matter is, it was already outed in the beginning of your run that you were paying people to go to your events. I'm sure that hasn't changed. All right, so in closing, as I get ready to get out of here, I ask you again tonight, which side are you going to be on when the chips fall? Because the simple fact of the matter is, folks, we are running out of time. You can continue along the path of either go along to get along, or you can continue down the path of, I think the way to make things better is to continue with the political correctness and to continue with the namby-pamby, free-to-be-you-and-me, hug-a-tree hippie crap, or we can roll up our sleeves, get to work, and put this country back together. It's up to you what you decide to do. I'm not here to tell you what to do. I'm here to tell you that something needs to be done. It's up to you to figure out where you are in the equation. With that, folks, I am out of here. I am your host, Rick Robinson. I will be back with you live Monday night on our usual time on right here on K98 Talk. Also be back with you live tomorrow morning for Finding Common Ground.
Game over, man! It's game over! When our water heater broke down last month, it was a nightmare.
It took five hours for the plumber to show up.
He charged us a couple hundred bucks just to come out, and then it cost another $1,800 to put in the new water heater.
By the time it was all said and done, I felt like I'd been taken.
What else could I do?
The smartest thing you can do is get a home warranty from American Residential Warranty. Their home warranties pay to repair or replace all your major appliances when they break. And they will break. And at the worst possible time, call American Residential Warranty right now for free information on home warranties starting at just pennies a day. Don't wait for your refrigerator to stop running or your ceiling fans to stop turning. Call American Residential Warranty right now. Ask how you can save up to 50% on washer and dryer coverage. Just call 1-800-513-6154. That's 1-800-513-6154. Again, 1-800-513-6154. Call now.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.